So next type of immunoassay is fluorescent immunoassay. This fluorescent immunoassay is called, in short, it is called as FIA. So in fluorescent immunoassay, we use a fluorescent molecule. Fluorescent molecule as an indicator label to detect and quantify immunological reactions. So antibody tagged with fluorescent molecule like isothiocyanate is incubated with the cells. So in this technique, what we do, antibody which is tagged with the fluorescent molecule like isothiocyanate is incubated with cells. So now antibody fixes with the cell surface antigen. So these are the reaction wells, you can see, which are labeled with fluorescent molecules. So we add the sample, and the sample will, sample containing antigen or antibody reacts with this fluorescent molecule. Okay. So in time resolved fluorescence immunoassay, what happens? A europium chelate label is excited by a pulse of excitation light. Okay. So the time resolved fluorescent immunoassay, a europium chelate label is excited by a pulse of excitation of light. So fluorescent molecule will emit some kind of light, okay, when they are excited. So that light is captured and is determined, quantified for the identification of the samples. The long-lived fluorescence emission from the label is measured from the long-lived fluorescence emission from the label is measured after a delay is measured after a delay. So we can, this is how we can quantify the substance in fluorescent immunoassay. So applications, if you see, for fluorescent immunoassay, these are widely used to measure drugs and other analytes, like drug metabolites, protein based substances such as bilirubin can be done by using fluorescent immunoassay. And most common infectious organisms like Candida albicans, Haemophilus influenza, Neisseria gonorrhea, Shigella, Staphylococcus aureus, and several viruses including rabies virus and many enteroviruses can be detected by using this fluorescent immunoassay molecule. Next type of immunoassay is chemiluminescent immunoassay, is called as CLIA, C-L-I-A, CLIA, chemiluminescent immunoassay. This test we are doing in our lab now. MAGLUMI 2000 is nothing but based on this chemiluminescent immunoassay principle only. Now if you see the principle of chemiluminescent immunoassay, chemiluminescence is the light emission produced during a chemical reaction. In a CLIA, a chemiluminescent molecule is used as an indicator. To detect and quantify immunological reactions. Isoluminol and acridinium esters are the most important example of chemiluminescent labels. Used in chemiluminescent immunoassay. So oxidation of isoluminol by hydrogen peroxide in the presence of a catalyst, for example microperoxidase enzyme, produces a relatively long-lived light emission at 425 nanometers. And oxidation of an acridinium ester by alkaline hydrogen peroxide in the presence of a detergent called Triton X100 produces a rapid flash of light at 429 nanometers. So it depends on the type of substance which we are using for the identification of the emitted light, okay, and the nanometer which we use also matters. Acridinium esters are highly specific activity labels, so their detection limit for the label is about 800 juptomoles, means very, very less concentrations also can be measured accurately if you use this acridinium ester in chemiluminescent immunoassay, okay. So acridinium ester And another one is isoluminol, is also can be used for the chemiluminescence molecules. So acridinoesters are highly specific labels that can be used to label both antibodies and HAT10s. If you see the applications of chemiluminescent immunoassay, estimation of wide variety of compounds which include hormones, drugs, antibiotics, nucleic acids, vitamins, peptides, all these things can be estimated by using this chemiluminescent immunoassay technique. And therapeutic monitoring of drugs is also done by using this chemiluminescent immunoassay. Okay, so this is about different types of immunoassay techniques. Okay, so you should know the different types of immunoassay. Types of immunoassay, if you see competitive immunoassay, non-competitive immunoassay, we have four types based on these two principles: radio immunoassay, fluorescent immunoassay, enzyme immunoassay, and chemiluminescent immunoassay. Okay, so this is about the immunoassay techniques and